أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك، فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول المولى عز وجل في كتاب العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam، إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار. Inshallah, before we start, if you move forward, so we don't stop it in the middle of the khutbah, inshallah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Holy Quran three kinds of the hearts: قلب سليم وقلب مريض وقلب ميت. قلب سليم, purify heart, and قلب مريض, it has a disease, and the ميت is dead. قلب سليم, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم, the one who come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with purified heart, those, the Jannah is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote it for them. That's no questioning. But the قلب المريض, the sick heart, the heart has a small door, let the shaitan come and attack this heart to do some sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, if you don't close this gap, you will get, your disease will get increased. في قلوبهم مرض فزادهم الله مرضا. And the dead, the people, they have no heart, they don't have no belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. Those people, their hearts like a rock, كالحجارة أو أشد قسوة, more strong than the stone. And those people, they don't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's in the Iman and that's in the Quran. But in our dunya, can we say to anyone who's believing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a disease in his heart or his heart is rough? We said this word normal in our life, but we don't mean it for the Iman. So we don't want to attach or link this part of the Quran for our dunya. Our dunya, when you see someone get in touch for electricity or something and he's very strong with that, say, oh, he's sick, because I cannot go for that. But he doesn't mean this sick in Iman. He's sick in the dunya and the culture, just as the personality. And some people go inside a fire, he know he can hurt a lot, but he was doing it. We call him, you know, he has a dead heart. This guy, he cannot do it. If he catch something, we say, you cannot do it, but he doesn't say, oh, he's a strong heart. And do you have in situation, you need someone really have a strong heart? We say strong heart. You say, talk to this brother, his heart is dead. He's not dead in Iman, dead in the action. Today, we're going to talk about a heart. You can call it sick, as in dunya, and you can say it, a dead heart, but you can say it has a full of Iman. But I will said it full in iman, get those inside being controlled by whom? By Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So nothing of them can attach the heart from outside or inside, because fulfilled with the iman, faith. Four hearts, we're going to talk about it today. The heart of Sayyidina Ibrahim, and the heart of Sayyidina Ismail, and the heart of Ummina Hajar, and the heart of Ummina Sara. If what they did in our time now, we're going to call them, they are sick or they have a dead body, dead hearts. We would say that. But they have an iman, full of the iman. Sayyidina Ibrahim, when he was talking to his father, and he told him about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and who is the creator, and he rejected his word. He was very soft person to his father, low his voice, very calm. You don't know what kind of heart when his father talked to him. Anyway, that's the relation between father and son. He was talking very soft to his father. Even he said to him, okay, I will say astaghfiru laka rabbi, I will make istighfar for you. And he left. But when he left the tribe, at this time, they didn't leave him alone. They decide to get him, after he destroyed the idols, what kind of heart he has to destroy the idols, and he's not escaped from no one. If someone come in front of any church today and they try to knock it down, you say, he's crazy. He has mental issue. But look what he did, because he has something else. No disease. He has a faith. He has an iman by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They decide to throw him in the fire. The action here of Ibrahim alayhi salam, he didn't reject it. He didn't say anything. Nothing in the Quran said Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was fighting back and he stepped back and said, no, don't throw me in the fire. And don't. If we do it now, we're going to call the person who's doing that, he's crazy, he's mental, he has no heart, he has disease in his heart. But Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was follow his tribe, and he went inside the fire. Nothing, no resistance. When he went inside the fire, his heart, what do you think about it? How strong his heart? You can say him is sick, or you can say he has a dead heart? No, he has an iman, full of iman. When Jibreel alayhi salam came to him, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent me over to you to save you from that. Just say, he said, the one who sent you, he is the one who can save me. He rejected. But he got saved because he has iman in his heart. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him to move from place to place, he was following the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What did he say when he left the place in Iraq? قَالَ إِنِّي ذَاهِبٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ I'm going toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one who will guide me. He never fight. He never raised his voice. He never shouting. He never did anything. He just in a very peaceful way, he left. Followed the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide him. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala testing him day after day after day, we take Ummina Sara. When Ummina Sara, Ibrahim alayhi salam asked her to go with her, with him to Egypt, what happened? Did she resist it? No. Did she follow him? Yes. She know they are facing a lot of problem, but what kind of heart she has? Strong heart, or she has sick heart? No, she has an iman in her heart. Iman, the disease cannot touch it, and we can, if in our time, we will say, come on, today, if you ask your wife to leave everything here now, we're going back home, we decide to leave tomorrow, that's it, we're done. You coming with me tomorrow. What about my house? I don't care. What about my money in the bank? I don't care. Tomorrow we're gonna leave. Do you think she's gonna follow you? Two ways. The police come take you over, or you're gonna be in the hospital. Either one. But she listened to him, because she has a beautiful heart, heart of the iman. No disease, no dead heart. You call it as you want in the dunya now. But in their time, from Ummina Sara, we say beautiful heart. She follow him. Not only that. When Fir'aun decided to give a servant, which Ummina Hajar, she asked Ibrahim alayhi salam to get married from her. Now it's another issue. Imagine a wife now, she bring a wife to her husband. She said to you, listen, I know you're good and you're looking for something better than me. Tomorrow I will let you get married from someone else. You think it's going to happen our time now? Even our deen allow for? It's impossible. You cannot even survive with one. I'm sorry. You have they control our bank money now. We have no over. Now you live in the United States, and this law in the United States, it crossed already to our own country. In my own country, in Egypt, divorce was 2%. Now we have 45% because of the American law, the family court. It's ridiculous. But my dear brothers and sisters, she follow and she love her husband. She puts her heart in the side and she said to him, go and marry from Sarah. Now he saw in his dreams, after all of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him, that's he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something. When he say, inni dhahibun ila rabbi sayahdeen, wa qala, inni dhahibun ila rabbi sayahdeen, rabbi habli min as-salihin. Beautiful dua from Ibrahim to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, give me something good. But he asked actually for generation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave him Ismail alayhi salam. وَبَشَّرْنَاهُ بِغُلَامٍ حَلِيمٍ. Nice, beautiful son. And when he started walking with his father, he said this to Ibrahim alayhi salam, فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعْهُ السَّعِي قَالَ يَا بُنَيْ. And stop here. A father talking to his son. And low, see the lowest of the voice, not ordering with tough and rough face as we are doing our life to our kids. Listen and that's it. No, he was saying to him in a very beautiful manner, Ya Bunay, inni ara fil manami anni adbahuk. Fanzur, mada tara? I saw in my dream that I'm going to sacrifice you, I'm slaughtering you. What do you think? In our dunya now, if you send it to your son, I mean, you're gonna die before him. He can jump on you before you're touching him. But this is, we talk about the prophets. Their dreams is truth. يَا بُنَيَّ إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَذْبَحُكْ فَانْظُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى. Relation between father and son. So the son replied back to his father. What did he say? يَا أَبَتِي إِفْعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ. More loan his voice to his father. Do whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking you. If'al ma tu'mar. Not ma ta'mur. Not do what you want. No, say wa tu'mar. The order comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a test. What do you think about the heart of Ibrahim alayhi salam when he say that to his son? In our time, we're going to say sick. He's crazy. But he's believing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what about the heart of Ismail alayhi salam? What do you think about the heart of Sayyidina Ismail alayhi salam? If he accepted the fact. Mental issue in our time now, if the son said to the father, come on, go and kill me. Then with this son, he says, a mental issue, we have to go to a psych doctor to see him. Because he asking for something, it's impossible. But he accepted the fact. Not because he has a sick heart or a dead heart, who has iman in his heart. He knows his father is a prophet. يَا أَبَتِ فَعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ وَنَادَيْنَاهُ أَيَّا إِبْرَاهِيمَ. Before the call of Ibrahim, فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ. When he gave up himself to him, his father, to sacrifice him, when he put his face down, imagine now, think about this picture, a father standing with his knife and his son laid down in his face, and he's gonna sacrifice, slaughter, will take off the neck of his son. If you're passing by, see this picture front of you now, what do you think about both of them now? So, what kind of heart they have? But they have a belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dependent on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he's walking for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ إِنِّي ذَاهِبٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي. I'm going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the most protection part in Ibrahim's life. Allah supporting him. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, Ya Ibrahim, stop. You trust Allah. وفديناه بذبح عظيم. We saved him by a beautiful catch from سيدنا جبريل come down to save سيدنا إسماعيل عليه السلام. Now Allah سبحانه وتعالى test this family by أمنا سارة. When أمنا سارة saw her husband take the son and his wife and leaving and leave her alone in Palestine, what do you think about a wife and her heart? What do you think about her heart? Do you think she gave up like that? She knows Ibrahim will come back because she has an iman in her heart. But Ummuna Hajar, when she followed Ibrahim alayhi salam, she was a servant, so she knew in her law to follow the one who is leading her. Sure, she followed him. But when he went to Mecca with some food and water, and then Allah gave him the other order to leave, just to go. What do you think again about the heart of Ibrahim alayhi salam? Now I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give me a son, now he give me a son. Now he's asking me to leave my son and go. And there's no food, no water, nothing. But he actually saying, "Zahib ibn al-Arabi, I'm the bin of Allah, I'm working for the sake of Allah. Allah guide me." So he start leave. When Hajar asked him, "Did Allah ask you?" He said, "Yes." He said, "Okay, wallahi, lan yudayyana abana. Allah will never forget us. So he never leave us alone." Now she has an iman. But if you think in our time now, if you leave your wife and your son in the desert alone by themselves, what will happen to them? Now if people look at them and you, either way, you have a sick heart or you have dead heart. Either one. But they did it. When you leave someone in the desert, you know what will happen? Last year, they discovered some bodies in the desert between Israel and Egypt. This is from the war of 1967. When they caught them as a hostage and then they left them in the desert, they die. No one knows who they are. Until now, they start discover these bodies. So people alone can die from nothing, from no food and water. But how she accepted? She has an iman in her heart, strong iman. But the test come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Hajar while she's standing and there's no water and has a son now, boy is crying, looking for the water. She starts running between the Safa and Marwa, between the rocks, which you have it now as a marble, and they have cold in the summer and little warm in the winter. And we still complaining about the Safa and Marwa was too long, and now they make something special for the handicap and all of that. Imagine it was a rock, and she was running, and every time she go to the Safa, between the Safa, go to the Marwa, in the top she cannot see her son, she run quick down to look at her son, make sure he's okay, and she run away to the other side, between the Safa and Marwa, looking for the water. What do you think if you see a woman accepted the fact that her husband left her alone like that? But she has an iman. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward this family, my dear brothers and sisters, by the manasik of the Hajj and the Umrah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let the brother and sister who went to the Hajj come back home safe, inshallah, and they accepted their Hajj. And let the people who didn't do it, inshallah, next year or year after, they can go and visit the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the house of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So my dear brother and sister, manasik al-Hajj, the Hajj by itself, it's a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this family in their time, can affect our time now to understand who is Allah. And we depend on Allah. Nothing called sick, nothing called dead heart, we do it for ourselves. If you let this heart connected and link it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you don't need to worry about anything in this dunya. Because in the end, the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah reward them the Jannah. And we need the Jannah. We need to go with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So my dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of Hajar, he said in the Holy Quran, "Inna as-safa wal-marwata min sha'a'irillah. Faman hajja al-bayta wa i'tamar fala junaha alayhi an yattawafa bihima wa man tatawwa khayran fa inna Allaha shakirun 'alim." It became a part of the Hajj and Umrah, the Safa and Marwa reward to our mother Hajar. And the place of Ismail and his father Ibrahim, when they leave the house, we go and visit there. When he throw the shaitan, we follow his steps. When he do the manasik al-hajj, you and me or everyone who follow the steps of Ibrahim alayhi salam, a place with no one except him and his son and his wife, now look at the Kaaba. and how crowded it is, how much the Hajj cost these days. And they keep raising the price. Even people, they want to go year after year. I save money, the year after they raise the price again. I postponed it for another year, because you cannot afford it. People that has no rahmah in their hearts when they make the Hajj package. They have no rahmah. They don't understand. Some people, they cannot afford it. They don't make a special package for the people who cannot really afford it, coast to coast at least. Few people who don't say the whole thing. A few brother can take them to the Hajj, or one who cannot afford it, send them to the Hajj. But no matter how much the price, today people cannot even walk around the Kaaba from the crowded. This is a ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Ibrahim alayhi salam to raise the takbir. As we said it in these days, the takbir is two kinds, my dear brothers and sisters, mutlaq and muqayyad. Mutlaq, that you can say it from the day start of the Hajj until the ayam al-tashriq, every day, anywhere you go, in the market, in your home, in your car, say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. But in muqayyad, ayam al-tashriq, start from the day of Arafah until the fourth days of the Eid. You count it 23 salah. Arafah, first day, second day, third day, there's 20 salah and the three which is Fajr, Dhuhr, and Asr, and we'll stop after that. It's easy and simple. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let all of us make the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to brother and sister over there, and let us benefit from their dua to us, insha'Allah rabbil alameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa lisa'il mu'mineen. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So my dear brothers and sisters, we need to see our hearts linking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Close the doors for the shaitan. Let your heart soft toward everyone. As I heard, collecting money for the poor and need and the refugee. Believe or not, 2 weeks ago, a group of doctors and nurses, they're going to Bangladesh in the middle of September in their own money, own budget, to taking care of the people over there. And those people, none of them Muslims, none of them Muslims, and they are going there to help them. Imagine about us. Kullukum ra'a. You're all responsible. We're all responsible. If you see something like that, don't worry. Give as much as you can. These days, the best days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swear with it. Wal fajr wa layalin ashr. Those days, Allah love it. Better than the days of Ramadan. Especially the day of Arafah. You must fast this day. Try as much as you can to fast this day. If you cannot fast these days, the day of Arafah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive a year before and year after from all the sins. So imagine these days, good days to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The important point as a believers, in these times, your parents. And I'm talking to the young kids. You have to get closer to your parents. And the people who still have their parents alive, in our time, our age, get closer to them, kiss their hand, see what they're looking for. This is the best way to enter the Jannah. The gate of the Jannah will be blocked for the people who disobey the parents. Remember, the parents will never hurt you no matter what. No matter how old you are, they always worry about you. They love you so much. If your parents are a little tough on you, because they like to see you the best kids in the whole world. So they push you a little, but they don't mean it. If you go behind their heart, you see their heart to cry because they hurt you, if they hurt you. But they don't mean it. But some parents, we see them get beaten up by their own son. Why? I don't know. What we call their heart? I don't know. In these days, my dear brother, the days of Rahmah, days of maghfirah, days of istighfar, days of the takbir, and people beat up their parents. Where are we at? Do we believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And they come and pray? Allah will never accept it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love the people who love their parents. They come after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ ولا تنهرهما. Learn from Sayyidina Ibrahim how he was talking to his father, and how Ismail was talking to his father. See the wife, how she responds to her husband, how she accepts what she is looking for. And see how the husband care about his family. He keep coming back and first look at them, how they are doing. Relation, a family relation. This is the day to understand the meaning of family. The meaning of family in the Iman, in the Islam. The meaning of family who is getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need every single person make dua to himself and his wife and his kids and his father and mother and everyone for the ummah. Imagine the people in the Hajj, in the day of Arafah, if they make dua, one of them Allah accepted, we are among the people get forgiven from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of this person. So it's not hard for us to make dua for them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted the dua. They make the dua and we make ameen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept their Hajj. If their Hajj accept and their dua accepted, it will reflect on us because they make dua to the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We said it every time in our salam, my dear brothers and sisters, fil fatiha, Rabbil alameen, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Malik yawmiddin, Iyaka na'bud, wa Iyaka nasta'in. We make ista'ana by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear brothers and sisters, don't let these days just to go like the other regular days. Increase your dua, increase your salah, increase your nawafil. If you fast, go ahead and continue, insha'a Rabbil alameen. Fast the day of Arafah as much as you can. If you can, if you cannot, just make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Get closer to your family, to your neighbor, to your friend. Make dua to everyone. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the hajj from everyone who in there, insha'a Rabbil alameen. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina. Allahumma ashfi maradana wa marada al-muslimin. Warham amwatana wa amwat al-muslimin. Allahumma la taj'al lana dhanban illa ghafarta. Wala maridan illa shafaita. Wala mayyitan illa rahimta. ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة ونعيمها ونعوذ بك من النار وشرورها. اللهم ارزقنا شربة ماء من يد رسولك الكريم لا نظمى بعدها أبدا. اللهم ألحقنا بالنبيين والصديقين. اللهم أرنا أبانا إبراهيم وإسماعيل وإسحاق ويعقوب ونوح وآدم ومحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في جنات النعيم. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات المسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم استر عورات إخواننا في كل مكان. اللهم أعن الإسلام والمسلمين وارفع راية الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم اطعم كل فقير واكس كل محتاج. اللهم أنت لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. عباد الله رحمني ورحمكم الله. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم وأقيم الصلاة.